So there's suddenly 15 people in the studio. I say 15, four. But, you know, it made it sound more grand, didn't it? Because I got all flustered for a second. The song had finished and we were chit-chatting. So I just, about 30,000 people come in, all to complain about Joe Spring. You're in the wrong place. They're very quiet, aren't they? Anyway, we'll carry on with what we had as the show before then. Are you staying in?
No, I'll go out.
All right, then. Who's he?
I just
followed him in. the bloke on the door was like, "I'm Paul Weller, I'm on the show," and this bloke was like, "Oh,
I've never met him before.
I'll nip in with him, it'll be all right."
But I had that one at times.
I've always wanted to come and see what a studio's like. You can get out now. Do you want some birthday cake?
No, I'm trying to avoid food-related products.
Who is he?
He's a guitar tech.
How is he?
Yeah, his name's Roger.
He should probably stay in then, shouldn't he? Roger?
I don't know, you upset him now.
By what? Well, we'll get Roger back in a minute because we have got to do a sound check and everything. And is he just like a roadie? Is that like a new flash name for a guitar tech?
Technician's tech now.
Oh, right, so he doesn't do any of the sound check and he just tunes it up and hands it to you.
Just shows you his belly.
It would add to the live experience if you had a roadie running across halfway through the song. And
what we should do, yeah, because it's live music now. Well, we were joking about you coming back in, Roger. You can go back out. What we should do, we should just have 10 minutes of music for a while, and then Roger should run across, and people in the audience can go, "Hey!" Because people at audiences at gigs have never noticed that bloke isn't in the band. It happens every single gig you've ever been to. You're there for half an hour and everyone goes mental and you go...
Well, it's a sign that it's about to start. It's the excitement.
Yeah, but sometimes it's an hour before. You know he's not David Bowie. Calm down.
I don't know. People mistake me before, you know.
So the thing is, Roger, you haven't got a mic. I've got headphones on. I couldn't hear a word you were saying. God, it's going so well. I tell you what, I'll play a tune and we'll have a sound check and everything. And then we could pretend some of these moments didn't happen. Do you want a bit of birthday cake, Rog?
Not fine.
No, all right. I tell you, I'll play a track from the new album. I don't know which ones you're doing, so I don't know which ones to avoid. Well, I was going to play Hercules, which I didn't think you were going to be doing, because Dr. John was going to come in today, and then, like I said, there's been some personal tragedy in his life this week, so he won't be on. But this track is very New Orleansy, isn't it? In fact, isn't it?
Aaron Neville.
I thought it was one of the Neville brothers. Anyway, this is from Paul's latest step. Sorry, I haven't even introduced anyone. Paul Weller's on the show. Clap and everything like that. And this is a track from his album. Roger's still here, chewing quite wildly, like someone who's taken some drugs, but I'm not saying he has. Hercules from the album. Is it Studio 150 or 150?
Whatever you like.
But it's obviously named after something.
It was named after a studio in Amsterdam, which we recorded the album at. Which we did back in last summer, I think. We started a year before that. But anyway, yeah. But it's a studio in Amsterdam, middle of Amsterdam.
But do you call it Studio 150 or Studio 150?
I call it Studio 150. Yeah, I suppose, yeah.
That's better. Okay, now we've got to the bottom of that. Paul Weller's here, as is Steve Craddock. From are you still in Ocean Colour Scene? Are you in Paul's band or both?
Both.
Right. Okay. And who else is in your band at the moment?
Steve White on drums still. We've been playing with him for like 20 years or more. And Damon Minchella, who was formerly with his band. That's another story. And
he's not in your band anymore, but he's in the other band you're in.
Yeah.
And how does that work?
Speak to my solicitor. And we've got a keyboard player called Seamus Began who plays live with us as well.
Right. The album is very... Because it is an album of cover versions. If people don't know, they probably should know by now because it's been out for quite
There's
a while.
There's loads of money left in the shops anyway.
Sorry?
There's plenty of copies in the shops.
And there's sales on at the moment.
Exactly.
So this is the perfect time to be mentioning it. But it's very... It's weird listening to all these songs, some of which I knew, some of which I didn't. But there really is, like, the Weller effect on all of them. Sorry, that's an awful pun, which was unintentional. I forgot there was a thing called Weller effect. The songs I didn't know, they really sound like, yeah, you've written this.
Right.
And is that just like an automatic thing with the band, that there's just, you know, this is our sound?
Well, I think it's always going to have that, because we've all been playing together for an awful long time now, you know, so we're naturally going to have we have our own sound. But I think also, I tried to pick some songs that we weren't that familiar with as well, which kind of gave us a bit more license to sort of make our own, or put our own sort of flavour on it, you know.
How do you, I suppose everyone's done their fantasy desert island discs. Which is a very weird concept, isn't it, having a fantasy desert island disc for a fantasy programme. But how do you choose from a lifetime of record collecting, a lifetime of influences and a lifetime of records that, you know, move you emotionally one way or another, to go, right, these are the 12 that I want to
have a go at? I try to avoid that, to be honest. I try to avoid picking my 12 all-time favourite songs, you know. I pick songs that, like I just said, I suppose, but I mean, stuff I wasn't that familiar with. They weren't necessarily my all-time favourite tunes at all. You know, they were just great songs.
So was there some that you thought, oh, yeah, I'll try to do that, and then having had a go at it, thought, oh, this isn't working?
The original list of songs I drew up was just more like you were saying, it's kind of like all the things I've always loved, like with Kinks or soul tunes or whatever it may be, you know. But after looking at it, it's just like, it's not a good idea because I'm too close to those songs for a start.
And also, there's an element, surely, of you've sort of done that in the past, you know, with when you're in the jam, there was always cover versions of songs that you've always worn your influences on your sleeve quite delightfully. A lot of artists don't do that. A lot of artists are like, oh, well, that's nothing to do with me. And you've always been sort of championing the records that love.
Yeah, but I thought with this album, it wasn't a question of just picking my own favourite, all-time favourite tunes, you know. It had to be a bit more objective than that, really.
Now we've got, there's 3 minutes till the news. You can either do a song now, or we can wait till afterwards. Up to you. Is there a 3 minute one you've got?
Yeah, you can always fade us anyway.
Yeah, okay. But if I shout 88 to 91 FM, don't be offended if it's during the song.
As long as it's in tune.
Yeah.
All right. Yeah. What key are you doing it in?
I see nothing.
I'm ready.
Get onto the newsreader, and they can read the news in key as well.
Just skip the news.
Song. Baby got a bird, mama got a bird to sing. Baby got a bird, mama got a bird to sing. Without Karina, sure don't mean a natural thing. Well, I've learned to love you. Baby, far call, mama, far called your name. Baby, far call, honey, far called your name. I would trade your love for money. Baby, you're my woman, honey, you're my woman, that's plain. Well, have mercy, have mercy. Baby, on my hauled up, mama, on my hauled up soul. Oh, baby, on my hauled up, mama, on my hauled up soul. I got a rainbow around my shoulder, shines like silver, and it glows like gold. Glows like gold.
FM, this is Radio 2 from the BBC. That was, of course, Eating Rifles by the Jam. We were discussing this earlier on with Robin Hitchcock about, you know, looking back on old work and stuff. And how do you feel about it?
Oh, I like it. I mean, I'm proud of it all, you know.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't sit around and listen to it every day, you know what I mean? But every time I catch it on shows like such as this, you know what I mean, I like it. It's nice to hear, you know.
Yeah, that's great.
It still sounds fresh. I mean, a lot of it still sounds good to me, still, you know.
Oh, that's brilliant. There's a quote that I often quote because I enjoy it so much, that Woody Allen said about Groucho Marx. He said, it's a real shame that he'll never appreciate what Groucho Marx is. You know, everyone else in the world can go, look, there's the funniest man that's ever lived, but he'll never quite get that. And I did think that. I was listening to the Style Council on the way in today, and I was thinking, you know what, I'm going to enjoy this more than Paul ever will, because he will never quite get, you know, a stranger's perspective on it.
Yeah.
Which is a weird thing. Anyone else from that era...
era. He's still here.
No, well, from that...
I know what you mean.
That era, we're talking about the Jam period, weren't we?
Yeah.
Right, were we not?
Yeah, OK, carry on.
Rifles? Right. But far more than anyone else...
Yes, we were. I got the point. You were right. Carry on.
We haven't been bickering today.
I know. I thought I'd bring one in.
Well, I used to be in the Jam. You can't bicker in front of him. I do apologise. But far more than anyone else from that era, there is... you sort of like, on the one end, it's like the Jam was really the cutting edge. That's an awful phrase, but you know, it was like if you were a hardened punk, if you like, you know, that was like the stuff that was really angry and of that time. But also, there's all the brilliant hits from it that are in the mainstream. I'm always amazed at the, you know, if you go to a football ground, That's Entertainment's one of the songs that usually comes on in the sort of quarter of an hour before the game starts. It's right. That mainstream, and it still sort of sounds really, really punchy. That's good. By way of saying,
God bless you.
I'm lost for words. It's all
Weller
in the same.
I know.
I might not see the point, but it's nice for anyway.
I know. You argued with me. Well, let me make my point. And you got to the end of it, and we all went, oh, right then.
Yeah.
Well, if I had a jingle ready, I would have played it.
That was my way of saying, I can't believe it, Paul Weller's here, and he was in the Jam, and isn't it magnificent? That's all, my way of saying that. Very humbly.
Very nice, thank you. I must come back afterwards.
Well, that's that sorted. And Paul's got
to speak for a great many people.
No, you do.
Make that incoherent gibbering remark.
Well, it's not so much that. It's more that, well, what's he going to say? Yeah, I'm fantastic. Here's another bit of me. You sort of left him with nowhere to go. That was all I was saying.
All right, shall I ask him something else?
Worst show I ever saw. We've done it in Statler and Waldorf. Yeah, ask him something else, because he didn't really ask him something. He just told him something, and he knew.
OK, what do you reckon on New Labour, Paul?
I think they're all rubbish. I think all of them are rubbish. They're all interchangeable to me. I don't believe in any of them.
They are?
That was better.
We learnt something from that, didn't we? Rubbish.
Yeah, but you didn't follow it on.
OK.
What do you think of them? What do you think of them, then?
No, I agree with you.
It's like one idiot holding a masterclass for another.
Yeah, it's totally right.
And then you change subject if it's not going well. We should have another track from... Right. Are you going to do another one from the album?
Yes.
Studio 150, which is in the shops now, apparently. And has been for a while.
And this is a version of Early Morning Rain, which is a Gordon Lightfoot song, which is on the album as well.
In the early morning rain, with a dollar in my hand, an aching in my heart, and my pockets full of sand, I'm a long way from home, and I miss my loved one so. In the early morning rain, with no place to go, out on runway number 9, 707 set to go, but I'm stuck here on the ground, where the cold wind blows, where the wicked is to good, and the women all were fast. There she goes, my friend, she'll be rolling now at last. Hear the mighty engines roar, see the silver bird on high, she's away in westward bound, far above the clouds she'll fly, where the morning rain don't fall, and the sun always shines. She'll be flying over my home in about 3 hours' time. So different. It's no earthly use to me, 'cause I'm stuck here on the ground, cold and drunk as I can be. You can't jump on a jet plane like you can a freight train, so I'd best be on my way in the early morning rain.
The time for the news again. It's not really. I just felt we got to the end of a song. I was all jumpy again.
I was news again then.
Yeah. In fact, can we have? We'll play one of the tunes. You brought in some tunes, didn't you? Yeah. But can we have another one? Because I feel really guilty now about ruining the end of the first one. It wasn't my fault.
Yeah.
It's up to you. But we'll put on.
Go on. Have mercy, baby, on my heart, up, mama, on my heart, up, soul, heart, too. On my heart, mama, on my heart, soul. I got a rainbow around my shoulder, shines like silver, and it glows like gold. Karina, Karina, Karina.
How good are you two at keeping like a tempo precise? Because there will be people who will now be editing those two parts together for their you know, the fan club website bootleg.
It's easier singing in Japanese and keeping in time, I think.
Yeah, well, that'll be interesting to hear how well they do it. In fact, if you've done a bootleg of this already, can you send it to us by next? Oh, we're not on next week, are we? We'll send it anyway. I'd like to hear it. That was lovely. But can we have another one in a little while, or are you? Yeah. Are you songed out?
Just gives a few minutes to think about
yeah,
it.
Yeah, no problem. Well, give me. Didn't you say you brought some tunes into that you wanted me to play? Because I'm more than happy to do that. By the way, you're listening to whichever you fancy. I'm Mark Lamarr. That's Mark Steele, the future of history. And we've got Stephen Craddock and Paul Weller in the studio. And Paul has brought in I Was a Fool by Billy Easton. It'll take me a second to just. This record player doesn't work. But there's another one here. Phil. Phil. Don't look away. Phil, what do you think Phil means? Look away and pretend you're not there. Phil.
I thought you were calling someone.
There's no one here called Phil, is there? Right. Well, now Phil,
what's
now you know what I mean.
That period? What's your favourite track from that period?
Bennett.
Which period are we talking about?
Anything from 1978
March 1985.
So it doesn't matter. Don't answer. I've got it working now.
People are fascinated now, though.
Yeah, but I've got the record working. So this is I Was a Fool by Billy Easton. It's not working. I'm getting nothing. Getting nothing on that. Nothing.
We better fill in.
We really should, because I can hear it, but it's not coming out, as it were. Yeah, of course I faded it up. All right, I'll tell you what it is. I've got one of these at home, and they are tricky. But although you'd think the fact that I've got one at home would help, wouldn't you? Right, this is... Let's try again. And if you hear silence, it's a tribute to someone. I Was a Fool by Billy Easton.
Come back, Jonathan, all's forgiven.
No, it's not. It's not forgiven. What? Oh, here we go. We've got something now. And now the engineer's walked off. Can we get a level that people can hear? I Was a Fool by Billy Easton, which is a record that Paul brought in. I'm glad you did, because that was a wonderful record. Yeah. Phil.
Good morning, Mark.
No, that's not good, is it? I just thought I'd get... Because it will happen again. There will be a technical hitch somewhere along the way, and I thought I'd train you up.
Yeah, OK. That's very nice of you to do that, by looking vaguely in the opposite direction.
Looking at you and shouting, Phil. What could I possibly mean? I was looking at you...
4 letter word.
No, well, we used to have some listeners. Until the Phil moment.
Got 12 now.
What sort of DJ can't even want a record player? Shocking. Well, anyway, there's been a lot of bickering. And is it Rog? Yeah. Roger's gone off to get some equipment that we need for the songs, but we don't need him now, Rog. You're all right. But it gave him some exercise. He looks a lot better for it, doesn't he? He's got quite a sheen on him.
He's lost a few pounds.
He certainly has. Yeah. You know when there's that thing that, you know, horses sweat? It's not true. Rog does as well, doesn't he? By the looks of the panic that went on his face to get those capos. But we're not using them now, so we're all right. So what other song are you going to do?
Foot of the Mountain.
Okay.
Off the Wildwood album.
Right.
Always drifting away, and I can't hold on. She just slips away. Sometimes a great notion so strong to desire. Come on, baby, let me ride. Take me off on a simple ride. Come on, angels, I'm on your side. She slips away, she'll never stay.
Fantastic, wasn't it? And you know what? That was because when I buy like bootleg things, I don't want only two tracks. So now at least people are going to get value when they buy it. There'll be three tracks. There'll be an unissued version. It'll all be great chat in between as well. Oh,
that was special.
You know what? I'm going to give permission to the bootleggers to use the bit when the record player wasn't working. Not all of it, but that bit you certainly will not be sued for. Oh, this record player ain't working, and then. The various hitting of buttons. The chit chat about having this exact model at home.
Incoherent gibberish.
They could, yeah.
Immediately know what it is.
And that's my assistant talking. One day all this will be yours. Nice. Phil! You've got to be ready. That's the whole point of filling. Anyway, Paul, who's the best guitarist out of you two? Do you have these arguments? Is it Steve? Oh, that's very nice of you to say. No, because I just thought it was very inventive throughout, and I really like the little mandolin effects you were doing earlier on. And
Thanks very much.
It was lovely. The Fellas will be touring from the 13th of February till the 11th of March. Cayley, Liverpool, Manchester, Hull, Glasgow, Newcastle, Nottingham, Blackpool, Wolverhampton, Cardiff, Plymouth, Brighton and London. And the album is in the shops now, as is the Wildwood album, I'm sure.
Probably, yeah, hopefully.
Yeah, you'd hope your records would be in the shops, wouldn't you? That's a point.
Well, I don't, yeah.
Yeah. Well, are you two going out somewhere today? I don't mean as a couple. I didn't mean...
are you going
to eat scones? No, you're both very well dressed. I would have thought for someone of your calibre, Paul, I mean, and you look fantastic, but I would... But such a voice of a generation, I would wear like a hood and people wouldn't notice me.
Right.
Not many
people do notice me, actually. It's quite
really?
Nice, yeah.
Because when I was driving in this morning...
A little mob outside that were always here, but...
They would recognise you because they booked you for the show. But when I was driving in this morning, there were two scooters parked outside, and I thought, oh, no, it hasn't started already. But I think they were just left there. It was just a coincidence. Oh, was it yours? Oh, right, were you following him around? Is that how you got in the band?
How did you get on in Woking, then, Paul? Are you a big hero for Woking?
I don't know if I'm a big hero in Woking. I don't know. I mean, I don't know how to answer that, man. I don't know.
I can imagine a lot of...
See, you learn nothing from the master.
Who's the master? Were you?
Yeah.
By not asking about the hometown.
Well, by not asking a question that he can't answer himself, only other people can say he's a hero in Woking.
Yeah, all right. No,
he can't go, I'm massive, me.
All right.
I walk there, they build statues of me on a daily basis.
It's not quite Paxman. I wouldn't... If I had Robin Cook...
Do you know what, fellas? You've done such a good job, and I can only apologise for the way we followed it. But we've made you look even better. There's no denying that.
That's true.
Because they hadn't rehearsed that last song, and it sounded fantastic. But imagine it wouldn't have sounded quite so good without the just jibber-jabber nonsense before and after it. Yeah, no, it was a sandwich of really manky bread. But just look at this filling. Oh, that's a beauty. Well, thank you very much. I'm going to play a record for you now.
Good.
And you can listen to it on your way out when you're writing your angry letters to your agent saying never again. This is I'm sure you're a fan of Curtis Mayfield. This is Gypsy Woman. This is the classic.